It's Larry here of Xbox Live's Major Nelson. Welcome to the podcast, show number 613. This is an audio-only show.
Larry, I can't see you.
This is audio only. For the past two shows, we've done video, and of course, we've taken the audio off the video and put it up in the audio. Blah, blah. Anyway, but here we are. We've been doing the past couple shows on Mixer. You've joined us, Jeffrey, and of course, Laura, you've joined us.
Hello.
And then joining us this week is special guest Graham Boyd. Hi, Graham.
Hi. How's it going?
We decided to say, you know, I know when I asked you to be on the show, I realized it was kind of awkward because we've done the last two shows on video, and you haven't quite worked your way up to that show yet. Yeah, so we'll get you there.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that.
Not wearing all that flannel. Wardrobe.
Well, my mom always said I had a face for radio.
So here we are. It's nice to have everybody back together in the normal show format. Well, a lot of questions, a lot of great feedback. Did you have a chance to watch the shows, Graham, even though you weren't
absolutely
on them?
Okay. I was watching them on demand. In fact, you came up to my desk one day, weren't you?
That's right.
Something else. And I was, Larry asked me, oh, have you watched the show? And I was like, yeah, honestly, I'm just about to watch it. I had the tab open on my
browser.
Yeah,
you did. Browser. That's fine. So yeah, you can hit that on mixer.com/MajorNelson. I've got it on my YouTube. But we're going to do those. A lot of requests to do them. We love doing them. I think we do. I don't want to speak for you, Laura, or you, Jeffrey.
Yeah, it's fun.
Yeah.
But it's a little more overhead because there's a crew involved. Yeah, there's a studio.
And we have to do it live. Like, we can't edit things out. Like, I've burped five times in the time that since the show started, but we edited them out every time.
And Graham was using all sorts of crazy vernacular.
Couldn't understand. We're like, nope, that's
not a word.
So
we had to edit it out.
Yeah, but this is the seventh time we've tried this, isn't it?
So anyway, we do it live and it's a lot of fun. But we'll be doing more of those in the future. The goal is maybe do them once every month or 2 months, whenever schedules allow. Mm-hmm. And I'm looking at you, Laura, and you, Jeff. So we'd love to have you on in a future show if you can
shave.
You've got cheek.
I know, I'm trying to cover it up with beard.
Goodness.
No, you have much better facial hair.
I like how you're making lots of visual references about me when we are actually on the radio.
I know.
Yeah.
So too many flannel shirts, need to have a shave.
Right.
No, actually,
thanks
I like the
much
flannel shirt.
But we're back here after the holidays. We talked a little bit. We had Phil on last week, and I got to tell you this funny story is, you know, we always talk about how we're very careful about things we talk about in the show. And I read this weird story on some blog last night about they basically took everything that Phil had said and verbatim and posted it and were just trying to make news out of it. And there really wasn't, Phil didn't really say anything. He was just coming onto the show. So that's why we have to be careful. But it was great to have Phil on. We're looking forward to some of the cool stuff we've got at E3 this year, right? Yeah.
E3.
I know you've already had meetings on that.
Absolutely.
I've had meetings. Oh, Jeff's had meetings. Laura hasn't had any meetings yet. You'll come in later.
You'll come in later.
But yeah, we're looking forward to that, and it's quite a ways away. But let's jump off on our normal show agenda here. We'll talk about what we're playing. I don't know who wants to start. Should we have Graham start?
I think we should.
Graham,
special guest.
Special
to start.
Special frequent guest.
That's very, very
you're the
nice
Charles
of you.
Nelson Reilly of the show.
I don't know who that is,
and neither do anyone who is listening to the show. Me and Larry probably.
I'll take it as a compliment, though.
Okay.
Well, surprise, surprise.
Yes.
I've been playing PUBG.
We haven't played together. We haven't been played together yet.
No, I know. Oh, yeah. Do you know what? I've only ever played solo in
PUBG.
I'm yet to do duos or
completely
squads.
You can actually like look at your inventory and not worry about getting shot in the back.
Yeah.
That'll be a completely different game for me completely.
It is a little different. Yeah. It's a little less anxious, less a little
stressful.
Less stressful.
So you're playing PUBG, which is they got just this past week they got their fourth update since they've launched a month ago. It's been amazing.
And actually, that update's great because it added the second controller.
Type B.
I mean, I was loving it anyway, but that's changed the game for me. Like, it feels much more fluid to me now.
You want
to
know what?
Mm-hmm. What's that?
I went back to Type A.
Did you?
I tried Type B for about 3 days, about 10 matches, and I what happened was I found myself in a close quarters combat with the shotgun. Mm-hmm. And when I pulled the left trigger, all of a sudden I'm...
You're ADS.
Yeah, I'm ADS. I didn't want to do it. So I went back.
Mm-hmm. In general, I feel like I've done better since we went to Type B.
But try it out because it's got some nice flexibility in there.
I think you're right enough though. Yeah, it will be trickier when you're indoors.
Yeah, I just have to rethink how I'm my approach to...
Yeah, exactly. Why not? But no, I'm loving it. Absolutely loving it. I got my first chicken dinner.
Yeah.
Like, two nights ago.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Solo.
Wow, solo.
Yeah.
All right. Nice job.
Well done.
It was a funny one as well because we were right down to the last circle. There was four of us left.
Mm-hmm.
It was on one of the farmhouses.
For those of you who don't know, you can't see this. He's holding his hands up about the size of a half dollar.
They all had a sandwich in there.
And I didn't realize that when you get to the end game like that, if you wait long enough, the circle completely collapses.
So here's what happened. Let me tell you a funny story, and I will get to yours. Is I was playing with a friend of mine. I don't know who it was. It was one of our friends. And so we're doing duos, and we're kind of juggling through, and we're down to the last few. He says, let's go to that. You know those funny little octagonal houses that are two levels? They're kind of scattered around the map.
Yeah.
We get upstairs and we hunker down. Well, sure enough, the circle starts closing in on the house. Mm-hmm. Now, here's what happened. There was another team of two in the lower level.
Oh, the same house?
In the same house. Yeah. So it kept you're right. It kept getting smaller and smaller. All of a sudden, the circle is inside the room. We're throwing grenades down. They're throwing them up. No one's leaving because we know we're going to die. It turns, and you're right, all of a sudden it started just slowly closing down to nothing.
Yeah.
And one of us had to jump out and kill it. It was a mad race those last 10 seconds.
Totally. Well, I was kind of stuck outside the walls of this farmhouse.
Sure.
And I mean, my assumption was the other three people were actually inside the farmhouse, but there was nothing happening. It was dead quiet. And I'm thinking, well, I need to do something.
Right.
I'm going to have to rush the farmhouse at one point. But then the indicator came up saying, you know, play zone collapsing in 5 seconds or whatever. So it forced me. I just had to bomb it inside the house.
So the circle kept going inside the house.
Yeah,
I see.
It was just collapsing on top of me. I was like literally sprinting inside the house.
With it coming behind
on the wave of the edge of the circle. And, you know, there was a dude in the house just as I came around the corner. So I managed to tag him once.
Mm-hmm.
And then he was actually playing just to be the last person in the collapsing circle.
Sure.
The other two people died.
Yeah, they play zone took it.
I headshotted him. And I swear, the second I headshot him, I died as well.
But you got the win.
But I got the win.
That's exactly what happened.
Well, I saw you put this on Twitter.
I put it on Twitter. Yeah,
no,
but the last 30
notes.
Seconds on Twitter.
Nice.
And I was like, because I saw myself die and I thought, oh, I've missed it again. I'm number two. And then it was, winner, chicken dinner.
You don't get to enjoy the chicken dinner.
It was midnight at that point and I had an 8 a.m. meeting the next morning, but I couldn't sleep for
that,
3 hours.
You can't sleep after playing that game.
No. Oh my God, I'm so pumped.
Yeah, you get so amped up playing.
It's great. But I mean, it's just like, it's one of those games that just is story after story after story, and every single time I play it, it's completely different.
Yeah, all
right.
And
threw
even those
the
games
notes.
where you land and you get taken out within the first two minutes, you know, it's still like an interesting story. So
yeah, I'd love to know your strategy, because I found myself in the situation. And I was curious what anybody else would do. Mm-hmm. Say it's just been a minute after you landed and you're running up to a house, but right before you get into that house, you see somebody else run into that house.
Mm-hmm.
What do?
You just keep running and just make sure you can pick something up as fast as possible.
Do you have something or you don't have any weapon?
Say you have a simple weapon, like a melee weapon or something that you just picked up along the way.
Probably go somewhere else.
Would you go somewhere else or do you follow him in?
No, we go in. I absolutely
you go in.
I go in and then I'll if I can't find a weapon or the other individual finds a weapon first, I'll make sure I know how to get out.
I live to
and
find
fast.
Another day. I feel like when we play with Larry, we're out in the upper 80s. Like, we're out real quick, or we make it into the top 10.
Or we go the distance.
Yeah.
I mean, what I was doing initially was I was working really hard to land somewhere isolated, away from other players, so I could get settled, get all my gear and stuff. But I think recently I've kind of flipped that, because I want to get into more gunfights early, basically to practice. Because I was finding that I'd be in a game with no kills for 25 minutes, and then as soon as I got into a gunfight, I'd be...
Yeah, my...
Out.
Sounds like me.
So I'm trying to
Get
in earlier.
To practice.
Yeah, there's two data points that I use when I'm playing the game. Is one, I usually use the Roomba method, which is I start on the outside of the islands and work my way in.
Nice.
And if you have a Roomba, you know what that means. Laura, I know you know what that means. The other thing is I'll also make sure I make a mental note of the flight path.
Yeah. Yes.
Because that usually dictates, you know, plus or minus 5 or 10 degrees off either side is where a bulk of the people will land.
Yeah.
So you want to make sure you stay out of the flight path and go away on opposite sides. So I'm very cognizant of that.
Yeah, because I like that, because you also know you've got a better sense of where players are coming from.
Precisely. Right?
If you're going away from the flight path, you can pretty much be certain that there's not players coming towards you.
Precisely.
So as long as you're watching your back, you can have a good sense of where people are.
Precisely.
It's such a good game.
Anyway,
so
good.
There's a lot of strategy to it.
Yeah. Wicked.
Wicked. That's exactly what I said. What else are you playing?
Forza Horizon 3, Xbox One X Enhanced.
And it says right there on the splash screen, Xbox One X Enhanced. You know, it's funny, I was in Albert Pinello's office the other day, and I should get him on to talk about this, because he booted it up and he was looking at it. Albert, you know, Albert's a car nut. I don't know if you know that. And I was talking to him about this.
We know that because he told us the story of how he named the S controller.
Right, after his car experience. Yes. But he was telling me how he plays Forza Horizon completely opposite than anybody else.
Seriously?
What do you mean?
He'll only use cars that he owns.
What?
Most people use it to play cars that they want to own, or right. have this fantasy car, this very expensive car. Nope.
How many cars does he own?
Apparently,
enough to have a pretty good collection.
So like 700 cars.
The answer is he owns 30.
Wow.
He's collected them for many years. He owns more cars in real life than I do actually in Forza.
In Forza, yeah.
It's unreal. So anyway, so it's just so funny. But yeah, it looks phenomenal, doesn't it? Fantastic.
Oh, incredible. I mean, to be honest, it looked amazing.
It always
already,
looked great, yeah.
But like to see it in 4K is just another level altogether.
Your eyes melt.
I'm just hoping one day I have a car nice enough to make it into Forza.
Yeah, there you go.
That would be a huge... Wait, no, still no Prius, huh? Okay, yeah. All right. Yeah.
Well, I used to have a Mini. I suppose that was in, wasn't it?
Yeah.
But no, it's absolutely gorgeous. And you, like, actually, I'm glad I had a reason to go back and play it, because it's one of those games I've played it like pretty consistently since it came out, 18 months ago now?
Right.
Wow. And I was looking at my stats the other night. I'm only 52% complete on that game.
Really?
And I haven't even done the final showcase. I'm like 70% towards the final showcase.
But you did Hot Wheels and Blizzard,
Hot Wheels,
Mountain.
Blizzard Mountain. Blizzard Mountain.
Yeah. Both so good.
My 3-year-old son loves Horizon as well. So often we go in and play co-pilot with him. And we just basically blitz around the island. It's really cool. But yeah, it's nice to go back. I played the showcase where you're racing against the vertical takeoff and landing jet.
The VTOL, yeah.
Which is nuts.
The Harrier, yeah.
So good. Like headphones on the 4K screen.
Yeah.
I need to go.
Absolutely love it. It's so good. So yeah, well done to the team on that, because it looks incredible. And then aside from that, I finished Call of Duty World War II. About a week ago.
Good for you.
I
need to get back to that.
I really enjoyed it. Campaign.
Yeah.
Really enjoyed it. It's the first campaign in a Call of Duty game I've kind of completed for, I would say, maybe the last 3 or 4.
Yeah.
But I really dug it. Like, good. I thought, you know, they tried to do some interesting, brave things with the campaign storyline, I think. And I think it landed pretty well. So, and some really brilliant set pieces, like Battle of the Bulge.
Yeah, I've heard about that. I'm not there yet, but I've heard about that.
It was so
good. You've seen the films, the movies around
it,
right? It's just epic.
About a year ago, I went through like a, we've talked about this, I went through like a mad sort of World War II history reading phase.
Well, yeah, if there's some, we talked about that because we didn't do this on the air, but we talked about the fact, and I don't know if this is with you, Laura, but like when you're and I don't know this, maybe it's true, but you reach a certain age as a guy like all of a sudden anything that's on TV or around World War II, you stop dead in your tracks.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Yeah, it's the weirdest thing.
You become Tony Soprano.
Yeah, it's the craziest thing. Is that right, Jeff?
I'll let you know when I get to that phase.
Such a youngster.
Well, you're kind of there already because you're having this Wolfenstein experience. We'll talk about that later.
This is true. Which is, I've learned a lot about World War II.
Yes. See?
Playing Wolfenstein.
Okay, there you go.
Quite the documentary, that one.
That was good. It felt very, you know, there's a great episode of Band of Brothers where it's, you know, they're in Bastogne and it's kind of Battle of the Bulge time. So it felt very much like that. And it does one of those cool things, Call of Duty, where it completely changes the pace halfway through the mission.
Yeah.
And you actually end up in a fighter plane.
Yeah.
Escorting bombers.
Have you been to the Museum of Flight?
No.
You should go.
Here in Seattle.
My dad's coming in 2 weeks. And yeah, I'm going to take him. We're really excited about it.
Yeah, it's a beautiful World War II.
It's lots of World War II.
Museum of Flight is obviously what it is. It's a Museum of Flights here in Seattle. So if you ever come to Seattle, you want to take that in.
It is definitely a place to stop. It's right next to the Boeing factory.
Yep.
Yeah.
And it's got
one of them.
And it's got a ton of World War II.
You know what it has there?
I love it.
It has one of the original Air Force One jets.
Yes, it does. The one that Nixon and
Lyndon Johnson.
Lyndon Johnson, and let's see if I remember the other one. A couple of
JFK.
Presidents. I don't know if JK flew on that one, but some of the presidents for sure.
Did you go into it?
I did.
Do you remember?
They let you in it and you can walk around
Do you remember seeing how you knew it was Lyndon Johnson's?
His hat was there.
Not only that, but they point out where the president's desk was, to the right was a little clip, and that's where he would put his hat.
Yeah.
He had a little clip his hat. So, and his I just thought you'd appreciate that from
there.
Being from Texas.
Exactly.
Yes.
His hat is still there,
I don't
there,
think he wore a
10-gallon
hat.
He wore a Texas, cowboy hat.
Well, I'm going to look that up.
Yeah. Yeah, you should. It's really cool.
Okay.
Anyway, Museum of Flight.
That question has not been on HQ yet. What kind of hat does Lyndon Johnson wear?
Savage question.
Yes, exactly.
Oh, goodness. Cool. But yeah, go definitely carve some time out there. I took my father there once, and he is a big history. Yeah.
I'm
nuts.
See?
Yes,
it happened to him, too.
It happened to him. We had to leave him behind because he wanted to spend much more time looking at all the planes and the exhibits than we did. So
good. You're going to have a great time with down there, Graham.
That's good to hear.
It's unbelievable. It's all, most of it's indoors.
Moosefit is, yeah. The really interesting exhibits, like the Concorde and the Air Force One.
Oh, that's
outside.
Right, the Concorde. That's
they have
right.
a Concorde. I had never been in a Concorde nice before.
It's claustrophobic, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
It's like so tiny.
It is so tiny, and it just tapers to a point.
Yeah, in London.
That's right.
Well, not anymore.
Yeah,
cool, exciting. So there's that.
Yeah.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah. What are you showing? Awesome. We've got visuals.
Cowboy hat and a one-piece coverall.
Yeah.
Okay, that's Lyndon Johnson. All right.
Pull off all the looks.
And then just my last one really quickly is a total change of pace is Cities Skylines.
Yep.
Mm. Oh, yep. I'm playing that on iPhone, actually.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I didn't know it was on iPhone.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
It's on most everywhere.
Oh, I need to get that then.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, because I've always loved city building games, and I was really excited for it coming out. Was it last year?
It was last year, yeah.
Sort of, yeah. But I just never had the chance to
play it. What are you building? Are you building a real thriving metropolis? Is it more urban, suburban?
Good question. It's it's called Aberdeen.
Okay,
it's inspired by my hometown.
But are you trying to put like the main buildings in and building around that? So you're trying to duplicate?
I'm not trying to duplicate it.
Okay,
it's just But I would like it to be a thriving metropolis. I'm building it slowly. I've kicked off a lot of farming industry and some logging. Mm.
So is it young Graham Boyd's memory of Aberdeen?
I think it is. It's a romanticized version of Aberdeen.
You live right next to the football stadium?
I haven't got a football stadium yet, but in theory, yes. Yeah. You know, a nice riverfront, a couple of rivers running through it, So it's good. I'm really enjoying it. I like that sedate pace over Christmas with a nice cup of tea or maybe a little whiskey. That was a nice game to play in amongst all the Call of Duties and PUBGs and all the other stuff.
All right.
Probably what you want to play
after.
You're
really painting a nice picture.
Yeah.
I would like to be doing that.
You definitely need
I just had this mental picture of Graham in his smoking jacket.
Yeah.
With a fire on.
Because I'm wearing my onesie.
And a whiskey brandy snifter and you're just playing.
Yeah, in a leather armchair. Yeah. Something like that, yeah.
But Foundry goes there.
I do find like the older I'm getting, I like games where I can actually just enjoy a cup of tea while I'm playing it. And there's not many. There's like City Skylines is one. XCOM is good for it.
Oh, absolutely.
Right? Yeah. You can, it's nice. You enjoy a cuppa, play a bit of video games and
recommend chill. Slime Rancher for that.
Do you know what? I keep meaning to play that. Yeah, because I think my son Finn would love that.
Yeah, he probably would.
Okay. I'll get it.
That's
installed
a good one.
Again,
it's very slow paced. It's one of those games that you play after you finish something like PUBG to just wind down before you go to bed.
That's funny, isn't it?
It just slows the heart pace down and, gets you into a zen mindset.
Yeah.
It's really fun.
And you
have sold
that.
Me on Slime Rancher.
Yeah.
Good.
It's pretty fun.
Well, that'll be a segue. That's what you're playing?
That's it.
That'll segue into what Laura's playing, which sounds like more Slime Rancher.
It's a really good game. I very much enjoyed that. I'm up probably into the medium or the high level of being a rancher.
Okay.
I've got lots of good slimes. I've got all the little hybrids of slimes. If you don't know the game, it's an economy building game and you basically farm your slimes for money.
Yes.
Because you feed them and then they poo out money.
Sure.
And then you go buy upgrades to your farm. And
we're
going to
get me some of these slimes.
I want some of those slimes too, for
real. Daddy wants some more shoes.
Did you play Stardew?
I did a little bit, but that one didn't hook me as much.
Really?
I know.
Oh my God.
Did you have a mayonnaise machine? Because that's when the money starts rolling in.
Yeah, some delicious mayonnaise.
Yeah.
I know that should have been right at my street. I just probably didn't give it enough time because there's something that had come out at that time and I just didn't get hooked into Stardew Valley.
There's romance.
It's a farming game.
A fight against a oligarchic retail giant.
Yeah.
There's a lot. That's there's a lot to game. It. It's not just all turnips and radishes.
That was my most played game of last year.
Was it?
Did the year in review, the Xbox Live stats thing, the email that went out.
Yeah.
That was my most played game.
Like, who worked? Did you work on that?
130 hours.
Did you work on that project?
I worked on it. So it was a team over in the UK that actually did the work.
Oh, that makes sense now because for some reason, in America, the year goes from January until December.
You're touching on a sore point here, Larry. Yeah, that was the biggest piece of feedback, let's say, we got from the community was that, a year in review should be 12 months rather than 9 months.
Right. Mm.
But there's a ton of like...
First three quarters.
there's some...
learnings for next year.
Big data reasons behind that. But yeah, you know what? Like, if people are listening and they did see that and were,
that's
frustrated by it or whatever.
We know why.
We
hear you. Yeah.
That feedback and we're looking at options. Yeah.
AC Bongos on Twitter. Hit them up.
Yeah. Give me all your year in review feedback. Sorry, Laura.
Sorry.
But, okay. You know, the reason I asked was I was interested to know, like, because it sounds kind of similar in terms of that forming to Stardew Valley. I wondered how close it was to that, but maybe not very.
I don't know. I didn't get too much into it. So I only planted a few plants in Stardew Valley. I didn't probably spend maybe 3 or 4 hours in it.
Okay.
Sounds like you spent
130.
Good gracious. That's a lot of hours.
Good for drinking tea.
Yeah,
again,
for
tea.
Sure.
Valley, tea. Yeah.
Does that, I think that rivals Larry's 120 hours in Fallout.
Oh, yeah, Fallout.
Last year.
Yeah, I think it, absolutely. I'm still going. And actually, I think probably The Witcher is up there as well now. Yeah. I'm bumping against that as well.
Goodness.
We'll talk about that.
Yeah. Well, I don't have too much to talk about this week. It's been busy. It's been a busy week. I just played sort of normal games that you've already heard me talk about before, like Diablo and Dungeon Defenders 2. I actually jumped into multiplayer, finally, of Dungeon Defenders 2.
You know, people. I got
you all... You did text me to say, hey, let's play PUBG.
I feel terrible after that. I really do. And I got a lot of people emailing me. How could you not play? I feel terrible.
But
my sister, who you met, Sue,
she heard?
She's like, I listened to the show. What the hell? I'm like, what? So I'm getting it from all sides.
Well, thanks, community, for sticking up for me. But to come to Larry's defense, you did try and organize.
I will continue. I will continue.
Last week, you did try, and it was my calendar. Didn't,
I understand.
Didn't
I will
line
continue.
Up.
I understand things don't work out.
Larry's guilt trip game is really hardcore. Like someone will invite me out to something, and I'll be like, I'm gonna have to tell. I'm gonna have to tell Larry.
So this is
that I can't play.
This is no. This is actually a structural difference between you and I. We've never really talked about this, like. I went through the phase where when I was working in radio, I was out every night till, 2, 3, 4 o'clock in the morning. I'm done with that. When I go home at night, like, I mean, I race to get in my sweatpants.
Yes.
Right? Yeah. And so I'm like, I'm ready to go. I'm not going. And
I come home, I suit up.
Yeah, you're going exactly the opposite. It's like, I don't even want to know. You know, I generally know when I text you or send you a message, I'm like, there's a 5% chance that you're going to show up. Because you've got a very active social life.
Well,
and I respect
that. Because it's like, I'm like, we're playing. And I want to. Like, all I think about is PUBG for the most part now. And we have such a great time when we play. And I'm like, oh, tonight's going to be the night. And my wife just texted me like 20 minutes ago, and I have to break the news to Larry. Like, we have a parent-teacher conference.
No, that's fine. I get that.
And I'm like, oh.
No, I get it.
Does my kid really need this?
Yes.
And you know my kid needs chicken dinner.
No. When it comes to your family, I totally understand that. It's just when you're out for your seventh, bowl of sushi that week.
They don't
plate.
Put it in bowl.
Plate.
There we go.
That's
better. That is a good idea, man. We'll get sushi. Yeah, I guess you could have a shirashi bowl. He's not wrong.
I'm telling you.
Yeah, sounds
well,
good.
Well, at least you two get texts. Here's me grinding away solo PUBG.
Not true.
Lone wolf.
Did I text you say, hey, come on the show this week? And did I text you saying, hey, I'll bring you over to the studio?
Yeah, you did. That's fair.
Yeah.
But you haven't asked me to be in your PUBG squad.
You know what? That's because I don't have an excuse. I was waiting.
You're a lone wolf.
Okay.
You know you're a lone wolf.
But I'll just tell you this. I'll tell you this. So I'm holding up this mental list in the air in front of me. It says Jeff, Laura, and Graham. I'm going to take Graham and slide him right to the top.
Great. Thank you. I appreciate that. Literally, no one has ever.
All right. Let's find out the man that people say his voice doesn't match his appearance.
That's right.
I don't know what that means. Like that could either be a compliment.
Somebody
does. I don't feel like it does.
Somebody said you weren't as fat as you sounded. I don't know what that means. Did you read that?
Believe me, I'm working on it. Great. Yeah, so too many, not enough. It's certainly not from eating all the chicken dinners, although I finally did get one, mostly by happenstance. I was playing with a couple folks that were very good, and I felt like I had a pretty good contribution, and then we got the chicken dinner, and the stat came up, and I think I scored less points than anyone in history getting a chicken dinner.
Oh, no.
No kills. And I had, my hit score was 3, which means I think... Someone was maybe spooked by one of my bullets. Didn't actually hit anybody.
It grazed a building somebody was in.
All I had wanted for so long was to like take a screen grab of my first chicken dinner and post it. I'm like, I can't post this.
Yes.
I've had significantly better games where I finished in 50th than in that one. I just happened to watch better people win and I was on their team. So, but I did get it.
Hey, listen, there's always players on the football team who contribute a lot, but don't necessarily show up in the stats.
I was the holder for the kicker, basically.
Okay, yeah.
Maybe. Fine. Maybe.
You were part of the team.
Yeah, I'm not even the long snapper. Anyway, it's a very important position. So besides that, you had mentioned The Witcher.
Yes.
And I'd finished up Hearts of Stone, which was just exceptional. This is not exactly a spoiler alert, seeing as how that came out probably 18 months ago, give or take. That was the first DLC for The Witcher 3. Just amazing. So I just
because it's Xbox One X enhanced.
Yes.
So, right
which
before
is why
the
I
holiday.
Went back and, you know, the
so imagine, I'm just going to say this. Imagine playing one of the best games of this generation on the most powerful console of this generation on 4K. It looks phenomenal.
You don't even need to imagine. It's
okay.
real.
It's
Go
real.
Home.
Yeah.
Get it. It's been on sale a number of times. I don't know if it is right now.
Why are you playing this?
What blows my mind about it is that game's 2 years old now. Almost 2 years old.
Three.
It came, three?
Actually,
what?
It came out in
2015.
It's yeah. 2018.
What?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Yeah, because I remember in 2015, if you guys remember, we had some of the guys from the Witcher team on our podcast at PAX East.
Yeah.
Oh my God. That's right.
And we were talking about it, and they were, I had this feeling it was going to be big. I never knew it was going to be this big.
No. Yeah. I mean, it's absolutely one of the very, very, very best games of the generation, and it still is good. So then I started Blood and Wine, and it's a whole new map. And there's like a whole bunch of other stuff to do. And so I feel like that'll be another, I mean, Hearts of Stone, I probably sunk in 20 hours into that.
Yeah, that was beefy.
And this one seems like.
So I'm well, to your point, Laura, I'm well north of 120 hours into The Witcher. Yeah. Well north of that.
Did you finish Blood and Wine?
No. When I stopped playing it about 6 months ago, and when the enhanced version came out, I like booted up my save and I was in a dungeon. Yeah. And I totally forgot what quest I was doing. It took me 20 minutes to relearn all the controls. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, oh, I got to change this. I need that. Anyway, so.
Did you get out?
I got out. Okay. I finished that quest. I'm now topside again. So I was underwater.
Did you see the tweet from Cyberpunk 2077?
No. Oh, is this there? They're saying something about E3, right?
Well, the tweet is just literally says beep, but it's got 50,000 likes and
what?
Like
interesting.
When did that come out?
So the 10th of January.
Okay, today has a recording. That's about a week ago.
Tweet
a little
for,
over.
Oh my God, their first tweet for
five years.
Am I reading that? It was their that's nuts. I didn't even realize that.
That's a long time.
That is significant, isn't it?
Yeah.
So their first tweet for 5 years on the 10th of January, 2018 was beep.
Beep.
So 18,000 retweets, 50,000 likes.
And you're one of those likes?
I am indeed, yeah. Wasn't about that.
All right.
So that'll be interesting to watch.
Yes, Jeffrey.
All right. So... I can't wait for that. I don't know anything about it other than CD Projekt Red is making it, so I'm in. So this weekend was the NFL playoffs, week two. First one I had to worry about because we had a first round bye. Mm-hmm. And I found that like I had too much nervous energy because I'm from Philly and like we just wait for the sweet relief of when we finally lose and don't have to worry about it again. Yeah. Every win means another week of agony. So while we were watching, and there's, you know, when you're watching the NFL, there's a lot of stoppages of play, replays, and halftime, and commercial breaks. So I was playing Super Lucky's Tale.
Yeah, you
between.
Were.
So I found it. I just had it. I was playing on my laptop. It's a Windows.
We were enjoying
Xbox
tea.
Play Anywhere game.
Do you have some tea?
Could have tea with Super Lucky's Tale.
I had something a little stronger than tea at the time. And actually, almost done with that. So hopefully, maybe by about halftime of Eagles-Vikings, I'll finish Super Lucky's Tale this weekend. The opposite of my palate cleanser, the most unrelaxing game you could play besides PUBG was Wolfenstein 2, I'm very close to beating, but I played through two moments that were just mind blowing and staggering. And you know, if you've played the game, you know what I'm talking about. Mm. If you haven't, nothing can prepare you for the things that you will see because, oh my God, that's it. I mean, you don't play a lot of shooters, I think, for the story. This is a shooter I'm playing for the story.
Oh. It's good, and it's a great shooter.
Oh, yeah.
It's just
the
stupid
mechanics
fun.
They're great, and it's really fun, and it's very visceral, but oh my God, some of the things that happen. We have to talk about that at some other time. And the last thing is, I spent a lot of time watching Overwatch League, which kicked off last week.
I did, too.
And so did a lot of people. I think they had over like 400,000 concurrents on day one. There is a Philly team, Philadelphia Fusion, which, you know.
There's a Boston team, Boston Uprising.
That's right. So I may have to get a jersey.
Is there an Austin team? I know you didn't live in Austin, but
there's a Houston and a Dallas team.
Oh.
So it's right in between.
And a London team.
London Spitfires. They're very good. They're very good. I would say them and Seoul seem to just be just like, you watch them, it's like running into a buzzsaw because the two teams are just so good.
One thing about the teams I wasn't sure about, Are the players related to those geographical regions, or is it?
It's where the ownership is. Oh. So, like, the Philadelphia team's owned by Comcast, which is based in Philly.
Oh, really?
Robert Kraft, who owns the Patriots, owns the Boston Uprising. So the ownership team's there. Right now, all the teams are playing in Los Angeles in a very nice stage.
Do you know whose stage that is?
I think it was purpose-built in Burbank.
That's the old Tonight Show.
Oh, that's right. It was the Johnny Carson stage.
It's the old Johnny Carson stage.
I had a friend who went to one of the tapings.
Video screens they've got?
Yeah. It's a beautiful
It really looks very nice.
Beautiful production. Beautiful production.
We need to figure out a way to go to one of those. But I believe in future seasons, they will play sort of a home and away, and there'll be a home arenas and stuff like that. That will tie it more to the cities.
Nice.
And so definitely looking forward to that. And I don't know if you got your free skin. I think it's still going. So
I did.
One. Exactly. I got my my Philly skin for Soldier, who's
Boston
my
Uprising.
Main.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Fun.
Yeah. So after that, I started playing the game a lot more.
I need to
Well, you play with your daughter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And she's quite good.
Yeah,
and,
she's very good.
For an 8-year old, you know, she's up there in the 8-year old pro league, I think.
That makes me feel better because Finley was playing it a lot last year, and I was a little bit like. Should Finley
Wait a minute. We need to get those guys playing together. Who does Finley play as?
Soldier.
Okay.
Oh, and she's Diva.
Okay, so they're oh,
very
here we go.
I won't let her play any other shooter, but it's so cartoony and it's so otherwise friendly. Anyway, so that and then
I played with
a new map.
I played with your daughter.
You did.
Yeah, we have a good time.
Yeah.
She's legit.
Yeah. There's actually a new map coming. There's Blizzard World, which is coming next week,
and
which looks really cool, and it sort of wraps in a number of different Blizzard franchises like Diablo. And Hearthstone and StarCraft and World of Warcraft and everything else they do. And there's a lot of like really interesting crossover skins and they just keep making the game very appealing to come back to.
That's a really smart map. Isn't it? That's really clever.
Yeah.
From use all their IP like that. I remember what I saw the like announced trailer for it and I was sort of half paying attention. I actually thought it was a new IP they were launching.
No.
Like a new game
I was confused. Yeah. I was confused as well. I thought it was an actual event. I was like, is there Blizzard World? Like,
well, that's right, because you texted me.
She's like, what's Blizzard World?
And I'm like, it's a new map. She's like, oh.
I was like, hoping it'd be like a Disney World.
Totally.
But
yeah.
For Blizzard, I would totally go.
Yep.
I would spend a whole week there.
Well, you can go in Overwatch.
Yeah, there you go.
Well, we should continue playing that.
What else do we have?
That's it from what I've been playing.
All right. Do you have any? I've been playing pretty much everything we've been talking about here. That we're talking about the PUBG. Looking forward to next week because I'll be streaming Sea of Thieves. Is it the beta? The alpha? What is it?
It is the closed beta.
Closed beta. Which will, even though it's closed, they have agreed to let people stream.
Yep.
So I will be streaming, and there's been a request for us to play. I'm looking at you, Laura. I'm looking at you, Graham. Would you like to play?
Yeah.
Well, look, there's room for four on this.
I'd love that.
So
too.
When?
We'll kick it off. Whatever. I think it starts the 24th.
Yeah.
Which is a Wednesday, middle of the week, next week, and maybe we should do that Wednesday evening.
That'd be fun.
You know,
that'd be so fun.
I'd love to do that.
We can co-stream. We can do all sorts of crazy stuff.
Yeah,
that'll be fun.
So I know I'll stream from my
from the Major Nelson Studios.
Yeah.
In Seattle, Washington.
Well, it's a lot of fun. You know, I know we've been playing the internal version, and Jeff and I have had some fun. Laura, you haven't played it at all.
I've not.
It's so fun.
I've only played it with you at PAX.
Oh, the builds have come such a long way. Such a long way. This game looks so.
Have they fixed the compass?
Yes. Well, you know what? I stand corrected. I don't know because you don't know if the compass is fixed, right?
That's right.
What was wrong with the compass?
Well, Laura and I, we were playing the game at PAX East. Yeah. Or no, I'm sorry, PAX here in Seattle.
PAX here, yeah.
And we're playing it and we had a quest because there's a series, you get a quest and you have to solve the riddle and it unveils the next part of the quest. And what was the quest, Laura?
We were looking for
seven paces east
some kind of buried treasure
that was in a
final the puzzle is a series of steps, like you unlock step one and it reveals more about step two. We were at the final step to try and find the buried treasure.
Precisely.
And the instructions were to start at the campfire and take seven paces or something due east.
Right.
And then dig.
Right.
And I was there. I was like, I'm here at the campfire. I got my compass.
She's digging away. Like, I mean, I don't see anything. She's in a hole. I just see dirt coming out the top. She's like, I don't see it.
I was digging. And then Larry's like, well, I'll give it a try. I'll follow the instructions. And it turns out your east was different than my east.
Just ever so slightly. And sure enough, first one, dink. Yeah, I hit the top of the chest.
Okay.
So Laura.
I blame the compass.
Laura was crying foul on the compass.
Right.
So... Joe was there, right? It was Joe. He was like, looking, it's very scratching.
He was like, I'm like, I do,
logging
I promise.
Bugs.
So we're looking forward to streaming that course. Now, if you were in the beta, the closed one earlier this year, right? Or you're an insider, you're going to get access. But if you want in, you can pre-order.
Exactly.
So if you're hearing us talk about it and this sounds interesting, all you need to do is pre-order the game and boom.
Absolutely.
You're in. It's going to be nice to be able to like talk about it and stream it, and you know.
Yeah, we've been having a lot of fun in that thing, and just some of the laughing moments. I mean, there are a lot of moments. We played it 2 years ago at Gamescom, right? Yeah. It was you and me and Benny and Ellen.
Yeah,
and we had a good time.
We had some of the Rare guys on there.
Yeah, we had some of their. Anyway, so it promises. Look, if you have a crew that you normally play with, I highly recommend you roll with a nice crew. Now, what's great about it is, I don't know if they've talked about this, so maybe I'm giving up a little too much. Is that there is, if you play by yourself or just with two people, there's a smaller vessel you can use.
Yeah,
which is perfectly manageable with one or two people. I actually prefer it. Because it's small, but
Larry likes an intimate.
No, gathering. It's just
too many people on this big gallery.
Yeah, there's too much going on, and where's Graham? And I don't know. He's under down below having tea.
Grog,
right? Anyway, that'll happen next week on Wednesday, the 24th. That'll go live. So look for details on that. Follow me at Major Nelson. I'll be tweeting out when that happens and when we stream. Looking at you all across the table. So
yeah, it's super exciting.
We got to
talk about the Sea of Thieves controller as well.
Oh, it's in the car, isn't it?
We had it on the video podcast that you
Yeah, we had
watched.
In the video podcast last.
Watching selected highlights.
I've got
the beauty, isn't it?
It's beauty. Yeah, I've got one that I'll be playing with on the stream next week when we do together. I'll show that off on the stream. So
matches your jumper. You got to wear that, doesn't it?
So jumper's kind of a feminine term in the U.S.
Is it?
Yeah, it is. No. But it's okay. It is.
I mean, you said it.
I didn't say it. No, it's fine.
Sweater? Pullover?
Yes, pullover. That's okay. Fine. Anyway, whatever. I don't care. Look, Google tells me I look like Eleanor Roosevelt.
I forgot to call you first lady.
I'm
one of our finest first ladies.
No.
She was very distinguished.
Actually, I sent that to Lauren. You know what her response was? Should I call you the first lady now?
I think you should.
His response was blocked.
Unsubscribe.
So yeah, did you download that thing and look at what you look like?
I haven't done it.
Okay, so we're gonna do it right now. So for those of you who don't know what we're talking about, if you have an iOS or an Android device, Google, our friends that run that search engine, they have a app that you can download. And if I can unlock my phone, I will show it to you. And it is called Arts and Culture. And so I'm going to hand this to you, Laura, and you can show them how to use it. Okay. So, and then we're going to hit get, it says, and there's, you scroll down and there's this, is your portrait in a museum? So we're going to go ahead and show them. So look
at
that.
So what it does is it takes a picture you take a selfie.
And then hand it back selfies. To me. Don't look at it.
So you take a selfie, and then what it does is it tries to recognize the features of your face and match that to a painting. Oh, that's nice.
Thanks. One of my best selfies,
painting.
Actually.
So I got, so we are going to say, okay, you look like Isaac Crosby Trott. Or
who?
Anthony DeWale.
I see it.
Oh, I didn't
or
see it. Actually, sure about that one.
He looked like Filch from Harry Potter.
Actually. Jose Rodriguez de Suchina.
You don't know who he is.
No, I don't know Harry Potter.
And this is actually self-portrait with flowered wallpaper. I kind of like
that. Oh, this is a good one.
He's also in that.
So anyway,
he's quite a dandy. That
they've got
the
painting doppelganger.
They've got all these. They've got so basically, it looks at all of these famous portraits, some of which are unnamed and they're just beautiful pieces of art. And it looks at what
that one's pretty close, isn't it?
That's quite a mustache.
So I did mine, and it showed me as Eleanor Roosevelt. Have you done yours, Jeff?
Yeah, I am Francisco de los Cobos from the Netherlands.
Okay.
I don't know. It doesn't look that much like me. There's maybe a little. He looks shifty, which maybe is the closest thing.
You're right. So, in any event, Laura, now what did you?
I tried a couple of different poses with my head and always got different results.
Yeah.
And some of them were quite disturbing.
Yeah, well, you're telling me here. You want to see mine? I'll do mine right now for you.
So, I had a 54% match with David with the head of Goliath.
No.
That one?
Really?
Yeah, apparently I look like David.
That is a very closed up picture of you, like very mugshot-esque.
That's funny. And I had one of an abstract art woman and another one with a very colonial looking man that had a stovepipe hat.
Wicked.
have buckles on your shoes.
Yeah, so I think they have a little ways to go for actually matching.
Well, this is quite incredible.
Really?
Yes, look at this one.
What?
Nice.
That is Colonel T.E. Lawrence, Lawrence of Arabia.
There you go.
Who I'm actually named after. My mother named me after that one. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Now you're happy.
Now I'm happy. Yeah, Eleanor Roosevelt. Boo. That one. Boo.
He looked more like Eleanor Roosevelt.
Yeah, I think the headphones have confused it.
Oh,
yeah.
Stop it.
I'm not so sure about that one.
No, Jeff's being kind. I can tell. Yes. Anyway, you can download that, and it's interesting to see what you may or may not look like. So Eleanor Roosevelt. So
I'm going to be Wikipediaing Isaac Crosby Trott.
In fact, we are going to put that as the special guest in the show notes for this week.
Great.
Instead of Graham Boyd.
Sure. Isaac Crosby
spinning in his grave right now.
Anyway, how did we get on that? Anyway, news. Let's talk about news, shall we?
So we don't normally talk more about what we're playing and what games are coming out and about things, but there's news of a person this week, and that is a new corporate vice president of Microsoft Studios, Matt Booty.
Yeah,
this is someone we should have on the show.
I've actually, Matt will come on the show. I reached out to him earlier in the week, and he said, you know, I've known him for a long time, and he's like, yeah, I'll come on when I have something to talk about.
Cool.
So he just doesn't want to come on, but he's really interesting. But I got a lot of stories about him, but.
So he comes over from the Minecraft team, and you heard it there. Once we have more to talk about.
Oh, before that, he was at Midway.
Yeah.
He's got quite the pedigree.
Yeah, I was talking with Craig Duncan from Rare, and apparently he was Craig's boss back at Midway.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he's like, oh, I'm reporting to him again.
Oh, that's fun. Great. That's the games industry.
Yeah, exactly.
Congratulations.
So back to the stuff we're playing, and we'll just go from stuff that's available now or new things that are coming out now through next week, actually. So there's actually a lot of betas in the next week or so. One for Metal Gear Survive. Mm. And this is a co-op type of game. So you're going to get to try out the co-op mode, and it's going from the 18th to the 21st of January. And you can just go to majornelson.com, find the download, and you can just go ahead and start playing that. Another game that was just announced. Actually, we're going to go to another game that had actually just come out. That is Full Metal Furies. This was a game we talked about a little bit last week, and that is going to be an Xbox Play Anywhere game. It looks pretty cool, and as they were saying, it's a game that when you beat it, you only just start to see the beginning, sort of like Nier or a number of other games where you got to beat multiple times to really see everything that's coming out. It's a fun game that you can play with multiple players in a couch setting, sort of a beat 'em up, and I had a lot of fun playing this at GDC last year, so definitely looking forward to that.
Cool.
Some big announcements on Xbox Game Pass this
week.
Some really good titles have come to the collection that I've already downloaded a bunch of these. NBA 2K17 and WWE 2K17. I believe 16 might have been in for NBA at least, had been there previously. So now you have newer stuff to do. Halo Wars 2.
Nice.
Awesome.
Has joined the collection. I know at one point we were talking about over 100 games. Now we're up to 150 games.
It's cool. Wow.
For one low price. Darksiders 2, the remastered. So the Darksiders 1, the Warmastered Edition, was already and is still in the service in Xbox Game Pass. Now, if you had beaten that, Darksiders 2, the remastered version, is in there and ready to go. Rime, which came out, I want to think over the summer, a number of other titles. But anyway, there's a ton to play and there's more all the time. So I would say this has really been, this is one of the better months in terms of just more stuff getting added. And don't forget, there is you can play free. There's a trial for 14 days if you don't already have Xbox Game Pass. Find more details on news.xbox.com and of course, majornelson.com.
We gave away some free 1-year passes last week on the show.
We did.
Didn't we? Phil gave some away.
I gave one away.
You gave one away.
They all ended in Z.
They all ended in zebra.
Zebra.
Zulu.
Zulu.
I did enjoy you reading them out in, what were you calling it? Like
NATO. NATO. It's the NATO, it's the NATO alphabet.
People were correcting you on that. We just let that go.
No, it's fine. I did.
Well, on every single
letter. It's hard to remember.
You were doing really well. This is what I always do. When I'm on the phone to customer services somewhere or whatever, and you're like,
trying to read something
off. They say, oh, how do you spell your name? Right. So I very confidently start doing it in phonetic alphabet.
B as in boy.
Right? Golf, Romeo. Right. And then you get to the point where you, M is always the one I forget, right?
What is it?
And then
is it Mary?
Mike.
Okay. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But mother is used sometimes.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
But you get to that point where you're talking to a very confident lady and you're like, oh no, I can't remember what M is. No, it's okay. I've got an M. Fine. Next. You were there the whole way through.
Yeah, mine is because I do the same thing with my last name because they can't pronounce it or they can't spell. So I'm like Hotel, you know, Romeo, Yankee, Bravo. Yeah. And there's always dead silence. But they get it.
I like Foxtrot.
Always a fun one.
That's a fun one.
Hotel.
Hotel.
Yankee. Bravo just
said. Zulu. Whiskey.
Whiskey.
All right.
Anyway.
The NATO alphabet. We should put a link into the NATO alphabet Wikipedia page so people know what we're talking about.
NATO. Yeah. Okay, I'll put a link to that. Just announced this week, Assassin's Creed Rogue Remastered is going to be coming to Xbox One on March 20th, and it will indeed be enhanced for Xbox One X. Ubisoft wrote a post up on that on Xbox Wire where you can take a look. We finally have a date now for Age of Empires Definitive Edition. Yes. We don't have too much longer to wait, about a month. It will be out on February 20th, and that one, we've been waiting for this one for a little
bit. Yeah.
And that's going to be coming to Windows 10 PCs for $19.99.
Bargain hunt.
Indeed. That was like a lot of people's first RT. Yeah.
We did the Age of Empires event at Gamescom last year for where we announced Age of Empires 4 and talked about Definitive Edition and 2 and 3 Definitive Editions as well. That event was nuts.
I missed that. I watched it because I was
so
busy. But yeah, that looked like a lot of fun.
There was like 300 Age fans, 400 Age fans in the room. And the atmosphere was incredible. And like there was people in the room who like Age is the only game they've really ever played, but they love it so much that they like traveled to be at Gamescom.
Oh, that's great.
Fun.
The nostalgia and the love around that game is amazing. So yeah, it's great to have a day. Love on Feb 20th.
One more month. Mm-hmm. So Paladins, Champions of the Realms, this is a game that is by, who are the folks that did, they did the big MOBA, they did Smite. It's the team from Smite.
There you go.
And so high res. And it's, it seems to be like, if you're a fan of Overwatch, of which we are, seems to be like very much in that vein with like very colorful and very different type of characters. And that team, it is High Res Studios. So the X Edition bundle is now available for Xbox One. Another game that came out this week looks really interesting to me. I'm going to have to give a go is Inner Space. Looks really pretty. Looks like a very calm, relaxing ID at Xbox.
Perhaps
title.
Even tea worthy.
Perhaps. Could do a new segment.
I'll see if I have to use
tea-worthy games.
Reviews. Yeah.
How many tea approved?
How many
teas out of 5?
And it seems like you pilot
many
different
tea bags.
Different.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well.
Leaves.
Sure. We'll have to see. Next week, I'll let you know which tea works. It might be a chai game. I feel like it might be a chai game.
Okay.
Yeah. And then two big games coming out in about a week from tomorrow. Well, depending on when you're listening to this. On the same day as January 26th, Monster Hunter World and Dragon Ball FighterZ both coming to Xbox One, and both of them pretty darn good.
Yep. I've never played a Monster Hunter game, so I'm excited for World. I think I'll give that a shot.
Yeah. I watched a translation of an in-depth, when they revealed the last trailer and some gameplay and stuff, and it looks really interesting.
Yeah. So. It's the first time it's been on an Xbox, right, that series?
It's the first one I can remember.
That's a good question. We'll have to look internet fact check that, please.
Yeah, I'll take a look. So, yeah, that's coming out next week.
Those are the headlines. It's a lot going on this week, as always. We're looking forward to getting back into the video studio, do the video show, because last week, with the last couple shows we've done, Laura, we've done Name the Game, but in a different way. Mm-hmm. We've showed the video clip to make easier.
To make it significantly easier for those that tune in and watch it in the video form.
Right.
But we don't exclude anybody who's listening in the audio form or normal listeners who also get a chance to play Name the Game. But of course, if you want an extra hint, you can watch the video.
Yeah, you can go watch the video on demand and go, maybe I need a cue. But not this week. Well, actually, let's award the prize for last week.
Okay, let's do Name the Game
You have all the information in front of you, right?
I do have all the information, but we need to roll the sound effects from last week. So that was Name the Game from last week.
Yeah.
And the game was The Incredible Adventures of Van Helsing 3.
Which, it's a Games with Gold title this
it
month.
It is Games with Gold title. Yeah. So if you want to try this out for yourself, go ahead and download it. If you're a Gold member, it'll be free.
It's Incredible Adventures, Jeff.
The Incredible Adventures.
The Mundane Adventures, we don't need to bother with that.
Van Helsing
has a pretty
does laundry.
You could say he's really raised the stakes.
Yes, he has.
All right.
No.
So back to Name the Game.
He's leaving him hanging there.
I know.
Oh, is that what that was?
The high five.
Not on video this week.
No. Way off.
Let's get back to Name the Game, guys.
Yes, sorry. So we had a winner.
We had a lot of people
who correctly identified it, but we only one of you gets to be a winner.
That's correct. We take all the correct guesses, and then we choose a random winner. And this week, the winner is Sean from Maryland, and his gamer tag...
Did you say Maryland?
Maryland?
It's Maryland.
Says ye from the East Coast.
Maryland.
Okay. Is that what you called it in Texas?
Maryland.
Huh.
Yeah. Is that surprising? Like, have you not heard that before?
Because we called it, growing up, Oregon, and that's not... Now that I'm out on the West Coast, I said that exactly once before getting, like, laughed and shamed.
Oh, no.
No, I think there was a class in Syracuse, one of our broadcasting classes, where my radio teacher made us pronounce all of the states and capitals and the regions so that we would have very non-distinct, non-regional dialects. Mm. So, anyway.
Mm. Well... I haven't taken that training.
Maryland.
So I still have the Southern accent.
Meanwhile, in Maryland.
So, Sean.
Yes.
Whose gamer tag is MJCaboose91.
Right.
Congratulations on winning. We have a lot of prizes for you. I was able to dig around
what
in
do we
Larry's
got?
Office.
What do we have?
And find a basket of games.
Basket of games.
To give to you, Sean. But first, I'm going to give you over 100 to 150, it sounds like, games that you can go try on Xbox Game Pass for 3 months. So, I've got an Xbox Game Pass subscription. Right.
Cool. All you can eat.
And the basket of games that I found was a big bundle of ID at Xbox titles.
For some reason, when you say basket of games, I just have this mental image of you arranging it in a nice basket with some crepe paper, and a little bow on the top.
Nice wicker hamper.
Yeah, right. Yes. you're just painting such a wonderful picture, Laura. Go ahead.
Some preserves in there as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. It's maybe popcorn.
Yeah.
Sorry, I don't have popcorn for you, Sean. Probably.
Just
want to win the games, that's okay, because all I got are games here. We have a copy of the ID Xbox game Full Metal Furies, a copy of 2064 Read Only Memories.
Wrong.
A copy of the, exactly, a copy of the Aquatic Adventure of the Last Human.
We need the Aquatic Adventures of Van Helsing.
That's
that might be interesting.
You obviously haven't played all the way through.
Okay.
But that's not all, Sean. I also have a copy of The Vanishing of Ethan Carter.
Yes.
Which I'm excited to go try out. It just came out recently. I have a copy of a game called Vesta, a game called Beholder, Inner Space, which is what we were chatting about earlier. It's that gorgeous game.
I should have played.
Tea-worthy game. And that's not all. I also have a copy of Fortnite Founders Pack.
Oh, nice.
Exactly. So if you want to get into some Fortnite, I got you covered.
All I can think of when I hear Inner Space is that movie from the 80s where it's the
Martin Short.
Where he gets shrunk down. Right? Was that Martin Short?
Space. It was called Inner Space.
Yeah, okay.
Was it Martin Short? And then was
Dennis Quaid.
Dennis Quaid.
Meg Ryan. I'm looking at it right now. I just looked it up.
Yeah, great movie.
Wow.
Was Martin Short in there?
It got an Academy Award for Best Visual Effects.
Oh.
Who knew? Good. All right. Anyway. Yeah. Congratulations.
Exactly. Congratulations, Sean. You've got a lot of games to go try out. Thank you very much for playing. Should we do a name the game for this week?
I think we should do a name the game for this week. You ready?
I am ready. Let's roll the sound effects for this week. So that was Name the Game for this week. It's really simple to enter. All you have to do is listen to those sound effects and guess what game that is.
Yeah.
And send us an email. You can send me an email, lollipop, at xbox.com and ccmajor at xbox.com.
Now, it's a little different this week because we're going old school. You only have the audio, no visuals. So you got to figure that out. Listen carefully. One entry per person, please. More than one entry, you get to, all of them get disqualified.
Exactly. Just send us an email.
All those entries go. Oh
my God. Yep. Unless you're from Maryland.
Unless you're from Maryland. Maryland.
Isn't that Yay.
Not to
Maryland
be
named after Mary, Queen of Scots?
Yes.
See?
It is the land bringing it all of together. Mary. Yeah.
All right. So good luck right. to all you Name the Gamers out there. We don't take entries over Twitter, so please send me an email.
I mean, you can certainly do that, but it doesn't mean.
Yeah, you're just not going
to
win.
You're not going to win if you send them to me on Twitter.
Yeah.
Send it to me an email.
Now, Maryland, if you're from Maryland, but maybe you're even from Blizzard World. And there's all these lands.
For I don't know where you're going.
I don't know where I'm going with either. So let's, you know what? Beep, beep, beep. Back up. Thanks, Laura.
You're welcome.
What else do we have this week before we wrap this lovely show up, Jeffrey? Do you have anything you'd like to?
No, I've contributed far too little.
Really?
I am but wondering. I've taken far
yes, too long dude. To yes, yes, yes.
I am
yes,
wondering
Laura,
if
yes.
you guys saw this announcement from Nintendo.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, the cardboard announcement.
Yes.
Yeah. You want to go over that?
So
you sound so excited.
No, I mean it's just
you
it's
sound excited.
I haven't
you may
I
may not be the target market.
I know I looked at it and I was like, I'm paying what for cardboard?
No. Oh, I haven't looked at the prices of any of these things.
Oh,
but
go ahead.
We all have Switches in the room. Do you have a Switch?
I do.
We all have Switches, Nintendo getting... Switches.
But have you finished Zelda?
Do you know what? I haven't had the chance.
Okay, no.
Hands on my Switch.
Laura,
my son has completely stolen it.
Laura,
I have not finished Zelda. No,
Jeffrey,
I started not it at least.
How you're the one you? I started it after you did. Remember that fateful
and
flight?
And I've sunk in probably like 80 hours
cross country,
but I just haven't finished it.
Where I was sitting in the middle seat, and you were so
I only
irritated
it on
with
airplanes.
Me.
Yeah, I know.
You were so irritated.
It was so frustrating to watch.
The Link Dying Simulator is what you call them.
Finn finished Super Mario Odyssey like 2 days ago.
Also good.
Wow. After about 2 weeks.
All right, I'm sorry, Laura. You're talking about Nintendo cardboard.
Yes.
What's the name of it?
So maybe I need your pronunciation Labo. Skills, but it looks like Nintendo Labo.
Well, I don't know what it is either because all I can think of is Gabbo.
For someone who doesn't like clowns, I guess puppets probably fall in the same thing.
So
anyway, they announced it recently, Nintendo Labo. Mm-hmm. We'll just call it Labo. I don't know if that's how you pronounce it, but it is a series of build-it-yourself experiences. So it looks like they ship you a flat piece of cardboard and you build a contraption to put your Switch into to help you play a game or play an experience. So the examples they showed in some of their videos was building a 13-key piano out of cardboards and putting your Switch into it, and then you can play the keys that are made of cardboards, and magic happens, and it actually plays the piano, which is pretty cool.
Magic happens.
I know. Magic happens somehow.
Step one, cardboard. Step two, ? Step three, profit.
There you go.
I think it's just one and two. It's just cardboard and profit.
Yeah, you know but see, so there are some that have the Joy-Con controller separately, then the Switch tablet screen itself, where I saw like a remote control robot that would pilot the Joy-Con controllers
fishing
around.
Game.
Construct a fishing rod out of cardboard.
Did you see the one where there's like just a little cardboard cutout of a man and you put one of the Joy-Cons on his back and the game appears to be to like make him face plant?
Oh, yeah.
That's pretty funny. Interesting.
This was referred to as one of the most Nintendo things ever. You know, they always come up with interesting things. And I will say this. I mean, I can't speak to this, but maybe you guys can, you know, Jeff and Graham, is that, you know, kids nowadays, they spend so much of their time with their faces and their devices. So the fact that the Nintendo's doing something to get people to be creative and build and whatnot is really cool.
Yeah,
that's what I like a lot about it, the creativity aspect of it.
Right.
Where instead of it just being a traditional controller and screen that kids bury their faces into.
Right.
This is now bringing it back into the world, into something a bit more realistic, a bit more human, if you will, where you're now playing with things and building things. And just the creativity of it, that they're able to extend that platform into now like 3D things, like a robot or a fishing thing, is really creative.
That. Right.
Yeah. Totally.
I don't know if they announced a date on that.
It looks like, I'm looking at an article here.
You can pre-order the packs now. There's two packs available.
Yeah. Okay. April 20th in North America and April 27th in Europe.
Delightful.
I want to show it to Finn. He hasn't seen the video yet, but I'm really interested to see what his response to it will be because he plays a lot of Switch. He's 7.5 years old, you know? So I think it'll be a good read on what he takes. The rumor I'd heard, right, was that it was going to be some kind of a Lego style amiibo build your own things and then have an interactive. And I was really excited about that. I thought, oh, that sounds really cool. And I could sort of see the connections from what they've done with amiibos. Yeah. And then they've got some 8-bit amiibos that they've had over the past few months as well. So I was buzzing. So I was a little bit, when I saw the video, I was a bit like, oh, okay. But, you know, let's see. The one thing that concerns me about kids, though, as well, is like particularly there's one pack is the is like a robot pack, which looks really cool, right? You go and it's looks very.
You put it on, right?
You put it on. Yeah. It's a backpack, and it's like got, it seems to have white like string.
Yeah, here's a picture of it.
All together,
did you? What did you guys when you were growing up? What did you have to play with? Because I remember I had an Erector set, which
excuse
was
me?
It was called an Erector set.
Okay. What did you do with that?
I played with it with my jumper.
It was like Legos that were made out of steel, right?
It was well, not
metal,
only,
metal.
Like Meccano.
Yeah.
It was, I think we called it Meccano.
Okay, so yeah, but it was interesting though. It was steel with like little nuts and bolts, things that would never get away today because you know people swallow them,
it.
Right? But back then it was a little more self, you know, you had to take care of yourself and figure it out. And what did you have, Laura, growing up? Did you have Legos, Laura?
I did have Legos. Yep. I played with blocks, a lot of blocks.
Right.
I had Barbies as well, and little Barbie houses that we'd make for the Barbies. I didn't have anything cool like a
Switch. Do you have the Barbie bus and all that stuff?
No. I had a Barbie mansion.
Oh,
that's pretty sweet.
Well, that's what she has. Well, that's Dallas-like.
I didn't get my first console until the Sega Genesis when I was a bit of an older kid.
Right.
So we had to play with things and Legos and blocks and stuff, which I think was really beneficial, actually.
Yep.
It'll surprise you to find out that I had got an Atari when I was 5 and never really looked back.
Well, we had one, too. Yeah. We had one, too.
Yeah. I remember the day that my grandparents brought it in, and they were like, here you go, and like figuring out what it was.
You know what people aren't going to know? Here's what people are, they don't know today, Jeffrey.
Yeah.
The struggle. Channel 3? Or channel 4.
It's
right? With the RF switch. Yeah. I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Or like the one program you want to watch all week is on and your mom calls you for tea.
Right.
And you've got no DVR.
No.
I mean, you can't find a VHS tape.
Here we are.
You know, you've missed your chance. You're never going to see it again.
Again. Ever. And everybody tomorrow at school is going to talk about it.
Yeah.
How old's Finn?
7.
Okay. Did you have to have the same conversation I had to have, which is explaining to my kid that something on TV was live and no, I couldn't. Watch it later. We couldn't skip the commercials. Yeah. I was like,
They have no
like
conception.
A concept you had.
They can't even imagine what that's like. I'm bored of like talking to him about it because it's just like, he just doesn't get it.
She got it now. Sports helped, but she was just like, why? Let's skip the commercials here. What are we doing? And I'm like, we're watching this live. No one has ever seen this thing before. Yeah. And this episode or whatever it was.
Yeah. Unbelievable.
Yeah. That was a concept that had to
I'm sorry. Done. I don't know how we. So anyway, thank you for that wrap up, Laura.
Oh, yeah.
On the Nintendo stuff. Interesting news this week.
Can I just a little thing on toys, right? There's a show on Netflix called The Toys That Made
Us. I've seen it.
So good.
Yeah, I've seen it.
There's 4 episodes, I think. There's a Barbie one.
There's a Barbie one.
He-Man, Star Wars,
Doors.
And G.I. Joe.
Yep.
Oh,
and they are phenomenal. Like, really nicely handled. Like, really in-depth documentaries about
fascinating.
The making of those toys and the history and the market and how they sold and then how they eventually flopped as well. I guess Barbie's still going strong.
Yeah.
But it's really nicely handled, right? Really
funny. It's beautiful.
And, like, lots of nice
especially the Star Wars one and the story of them. It's must watch.
And really emotional at the end as well. Yeah.
Well, yeah, because for those of us who are a little older, we grew up with those things.
Yeah,
and it's interesting. We never really knew. I mean, they were just toys.
Yeah.
Now we know the story and the people that designed
100%,
them. Fascinating.
Yeah. So if you're a child of the 80s like me.
Or the child of the 70s like me.
That. Yeah, there you go.
Or the 90s like Laura.
Yeah.
We should do a Laura reacts. Yeah.
No.
One thing I actually
child
just hit
50s,
right
Jeff.
Around. Yeah, I play with my Chevy with fins on
a hoop and a stick.
Yeah, but I feel like I've made
and
a
joke shotgun
about Larry before, and now it got turned on me. Do I? Yeah. Anyway,
what a shotgun. Did you say? My gosh,
I had cap guns.
I did too.
Yeah, and they did not have an orange tip.
Nope.
Anyway, so right before we start recording here, the Tomb Raider movie, the second trailer just dropped with Alicia Vikander as Lara. It looked really good. This was really good. It looks like this movie very closely seems to be very similar to the Tomb Raider reboot from 2013, which was fantastic game. And if you like that, this looks like it could be, it definitely, the first trailer was like, this one is good. Plus it has a sort of redo of Survivor by Destiny's Child. So, yeah, it works. It works.
Cool. It need works. To catch up on that.
Mm-hmm. You should. Yeah. It's 2 minutes and 24 seconds. I'll link to it out in the show notes.
How are you feeling about Ready Player One?
All right. So I read the book like 3 years ago. When we were in the desert.
Well, that started this whole thing.
Yeah. And, but I mean, the book had already been out at that point.
No, but that started the whole movie thing.
Yeah, that's right. That's
because, right. Do you know the story?
Yeah.
No, I don't think so.
When Jeff and I went out to the desert.
To uncover E.T.
In the landfill. And this stench. Ernie Klein shows up in his DeLorean. Do you remember?
His DeLorean.
Okay.
In George R.R. Martin's DeLorean.
Wow. With the doors up. Do you remember? Because I remember you and I were standing together, and I was like, we heard this racket, and I'm like, what the hell is that? And here he comes screaming into this landfill, and
the gold wing doors were up, and he was blasting the E.T. theme song.
Yeah, so he shows up ready to go. Anyway, so it was really nice. We had a nice chat with him. Yeah. He met Zach Penn, the director.
Of the E.T. documentary thing. Making on E.T.
Okay, so that's all great. The documentary comes out. Yeah, everything's great. Years later, actually this past summer when I was at Comic-Con, Zach comes up to me and puts his arms around and says, oh, it's great to see you again. We had such a great time. That was such a great thing. He says, I want to thank you. I'm like, what are you talking about? He said, because of that event, which Microsoft helped bring to the public, he had met Ernie Klein. And when Spielberg came and wanted to do the movie, Ernie said, I want Zach to write it because they had met out there. So it was this bizarre.
You need to get
my God, you're telling me.
Or a kickback.
For something. So that was just, I was like, okay, so I got a little excited when he told me that. I was like, really? I'm still a nerd at heart. But anyway, that was, so I'm really excited to see. I haven't watched that much. Because I want to go into...
Almost none, yeah.
I watched zero of any of the trailers. I'm trying to avoid it.
Yeah, I read the book a few years ago and I enjoyed it. You know, it wasn't like whatever literature, but it was a fun read.
Yeah.
I feel like there's been a huge backlash and that I don't understand. I'm from the camp of if you don't like it, but other people like it, like let them like it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Like why do you care if I don't know. People take things a little too personally, I think, with pop culture, Star Wars being another one. Whatever. I think I'm going to see the movie.
Yeah. Oh, me too.
It should be fun either way.
Yeah.
Right?
I read the book after there was news about the movie. I think maybe after the first trailer as well, actually. And I sort of thought, I should catch up on this. And, you know, I enjoyed it, but as I was reading it, I was thinking, look, if they do this movie right, this could be phenomenal.
Yeah. So we'll see. We'll see. I'm going to try to email them and see if, I'll see if I can get us a screening to go see it before it comes out.
Ooh,
if
you guys want to see it. This is good. Finally, using your powers for good.
Wow, stop it. Anyway, all right, we got to wrap up the show because we got to let folks go here. You all need to get back to work. Oh, I need to get back to work.
Right?
Did I just do a y'all?
I think you did.
Oh, wow. Sorry about that.
Take it back to your
y'all need to get back to Maryland. So, I listen, Graham, thank you for coming by.
My pleasure. Thank you.
It's always good to see you. Maybe you'll join us at a future show when we do it on the TV.
I would love to. I will change my shirt. Have a shave. Make sure I dress up accordingly.
Well, whatever you do.
I might cosplay as my Google dude, Trot.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do that.
Okay, good, isn't it?
Joining us today, special guest. We need to find out what his story is.
Yes.
Okay, look him up. So, Laura, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
And then, of course, Jeff, you can find everybody on Twitter. Jeff, why don't you tell where they can find you? If you have any suggestions or complaints, you can send them to
the complaint desk at Jeff Rubenstein.
Okay. Of course, you can find Laura at.
You can find me on Twitter at Laura Lollipop.
Graham?
Yeah, on Twitter and Instagram at AC Bones.
And of course, I'm also on all those things as Major Nelson as well. All right, gang, we'll talk to you next time, and thank you for listening. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye-bye.
See you later.